Hey guys, this is Austin, and this is the brand new Lenovo Fab 2 Pro in all its red bubble wrap glory. So, when Lenovo reached out and wanted to sponsor a video on their brand new Fab 2 Pro, they sold me with one word, Tango. And no, not my amazing dance skills. This is the first Google Tango enabled phone, and it's full of confetti. We need more color on the table. Okay, so a scale of 1 to 10, how much do I need to move the confetti off the table right now? Really?
Yeah.
All right, confetti stays, executive decision from Ken. So this is the Lenovo Fab 2 Pro. This is a very tall box. So Project Tango is something that Google's been working on for a little while now, and this is the first phone that's actually shipping with it enabled. And what this essentially allows you to do is get a much more realistic augmented reality experience, which might not sound exciting until you see what this thing can actually do. Ooh. that's a large phone. So this guy is rocking a 6.4 inch QHD display. When you consider that this screen is essentially your portal into the augmented world, as goofy as that sounds, having a larger display actually does make sense. So to put in perspective just how big the Fab 2 Pro is, I have a Google Pixel, and as you can see, this is a big phone. So might not be the best choice for your skinny jeans, but it's packing some serious power. So the Fab 2 is rocking a custom Snapdragon 652 processor that's specifically made for Google Tango, with that 6.4 inch 1440p display, as well as 4 GB of memory, 64 gigs of storage, and it's running the latest build of Android Marshmallow. What I'm really curious about are the cameras. So on the top, there's a fairly standard looking smartphone camera with a couple sensors below that. However, there is an absolutely enormous camera in the middle, and I'm really curious what that actually does. I'm sure it uses some kind of fusion of all these sensors and cameras to build the AR experience, but that is probably the biggest smartphone camera I've ever seen. While it's definitely on the beefier side, the Fab 2 Pro is a nice piece of hardware. So it's all actual metal, you get that nice big display, and there's some nice little touches like there are exposed screws on the bottom. It's on the bigger side, however, when you consider just how much tech is packed in here, it's sort of a different style of smartphone. Discover Tango, an introduction to the Tango experience. Walk to explore, allow for a clear space around you during, oh, okay. So I guess it's using those sensors to actually kind of build a depth map around where the room is. Oh, hello.
Like there's literally just a plant growing underneath the table.
So once you get into the interface, you can use this like any other Android phone. However, what's cool are a lot of the specific Tango apps that are made for this. So the first app is actually something that's pretty practical. This is Wayfair Measure. So the idea is, say you're gonna go buy some furniture, you can actually put the furniture in your space and see how it looks. That is actually really cool.
You can see the exact dimensions around it.
So say that I was gonna buy this chair, I would know that maybe I have some furniture around it or to the side of it, and I know that's actually gonna fit. So with a little bit more room to work with, we can try some of the other demos such as Hollow. So I now see Ken, but I can add a hologram. So let's do the Hollow Fun Pack. I want the wrestler dude. Oh. This is something that most phones can't do just because, while it's easy enough to add a little bit of an AR element to a game such as Pokemon Go, to be able to actually get full tracking so that you can walk around in full 3D space, you can get close, you can step away, and it doesn't lose track of where he is, right? So he's standing on that exact spot no matter where I stand. All right, he's got the moves. What's cool about this is that while it seems like a really simple sort of thing, it's surprisingly good, right? So it's almost tricking my brain to the point where I look at this on screen, I'm like, oh, the guy's standing there, then I move the phone, and he's obviously not there. Like, it's a simple thing, but it's enough to really kind of trick you. It's better than it should be, honestly. Next, we have Domino World. See, this is another case where the tracking is solid. On this table, like, the shadows are here, I can get nice and close. There he goes. Oh, all my hard work. God, do you see that? I like reached my hand out to catch the domino. It's weird at how good it is at tricking you into thinking it's real. Like, it was just an instinct. I wanted to reach out and catch the domino because I saw it was about to fall on the floor. VR essentially replaces your reality, right? You're entirely in that world. It's all digital. Whereas AR allows you to actually walk around in the real world and add digital elements to it. It sounds like it's a weird distinction, but it is a huge difference. So is this for everybody? No. But when you consider that this is something that you can actually go buy today, it is a really cool piece of tech.
And the cool thing is you're really not losing anything. You're getting a rock solid Android smartphone to begin with, and all the extra Tango features are just icing on the cake. And especially when you give it another 6 months to a year for some of these apps and games to get even better, this is gonna be a killer package. If you guys wanna know more about the Fab 2 Pro, the links will be in the description. And I'm curious, what do you think about this and Google Tango? Let me know in the comments below and I will catch you on the next one.